William is certainly not giving up in his battle towards the British Broadcasting Corporation. But what could happen now? Hi, good morning, Neil. Sean here in the heart of London. Thank you for joining me today. Lovely to see one and all. And of course, I always love to say this, welcome one and all brand new subscribers. Hope you're enjoying the channel. Hope you're enjoying a lot of the fun that we provide also. And thank you so much for some of your warm comments about some of the other lighter stories that we've covered recently. I do enjoy them, don't you? I particularly enjoyed that story about Camilla and of course the visit to the local cinema in Marlborough in Wiltshire. It is really one of those special places. And I don't know about you, but I think people want to go back to cinema like that because I think it's more, dare I say that word, inclusive. It feels like a proper night out. You know, there's big cavernous places that you go to and you think, I'm a sat in a shed or something. You know, the golden palaces of variety, those wonderful cinemas. Oh, I'm taking myself back now, but back as ever to your breaking royal story of the day. Now, as we know, Prince William has an ongoing battle with the BBC. That's all, of course, to do with a tawdry documentary, The Princes and the Press. They refused to back down and send him copies so that he could see in advance if there was anything, of course, that they didn't agree with. And then they had to release an official statement, not just from Kensington Palace, but St James's Palace and, of course, Clarence House too. That's how strongly the BBC felt about that particular programme. And as it's emerged, and we've told you also on the channel, the main presenter of that show was no monarchist. He's very anti-monarchist, in fact, so much so that he had to issue a grovelling apology on social media to basically say he's had a rethink about what he thinks about the monarchy. Obviously, he's rethinking about the £250,000 a year salary that he picks up from the BBC, alongside those wonderful perks too. You know the ones I mean that you can find online, and all the expenses that apparently it costs just to make that type of programme. But let's just park that there for now. Another main event in the royal calendar is none other than the wonderful patronage of His Royal Highness Prince William and of course the Duchess of Cambridge, who attend yearly the well-liked, in fact, BAFTA Film and Television Awards. Now, BAFTA to me is one of those things, I'm not really a fan. I've covered it for many years and it's one of those love fests, you know? But what it does do, because of Prince William attending, is really raise the profile. And I often think if you're going to win a prize, why not have it presented to you by none other than His Royal Highness Prince William? What a coup that is. And of course, on a more serious note, their basically association to the BAFTAs truly does help the British film and television industry. Now, Prince William is considering yet another BBC pullout. And let me explain this behind this particular thought process. Every year that is screened on primetime BBC One, the BAFTAs that is, normally on a Sunday night in February. Well attended, good ratings for the BBC. But Prince William, as you can imagine, is looking at all things BBC right now and pondering the effects of whether it's still viable to be associated with the British Broadcasting Corporation. One idea which we told you about on the channel a few days ago is simply this, that they could simply go down the streaming route. This would be far more effective. And what Prince William, and we're told, also truly believes is that they could reach a younger audience, more people actively involved getting into the arts and seeing exactly what BAFTA's all about. It does make sense because less and less people are watching traditional television, as you can imagine. Now, what's also interesting, I find, is this particular element of it. If they decide to go down the streaming route, as I say, it would be cheaper for BAFTA, and of course, they would get, no doubt, a bigger audience. But this really would be the final nail in the coffin between the British monarchy and, of course, the British Broadcasting Corporation. What a shambles that this has become when you think about it. All to do with the fact that someone wanted to make a documentary slighting the two princes and of course the media and the press. What truly emerged about that documentary though was it was particularly one-sided, as we all saw. I don't need to go into major detail, but right now the BBC could not be lower rating in the popularity of course the license fee payers here in the United Kingdom, and no doubt more so in the palaces of the monarchy. Neil Sean, Westminster, London.